Considering 413,000 Australians are living with dementia and this figure is rising steadily as the population ages. Now, this sobering statistic is led by Cook Maggie Beer and Professor Ralph Martins to team up and develop a We Are What We Eat strategy to fight dementia. Based on the latest scientific research, Maggie has created more than 200 recipes to help provide the nutrients needed for optimum brain health. Let's welcome Maggie and Ralph to the show. Welcome, guys.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Maggie, first of all, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your burnt fig and caramel ice cream. It has been wonderful for me in my pregnancy. Second of all, what made you decide to collaborate on such an important topic? Issue?
Well, I guess the thing with us is that we met when I was made Senior Australian of the Year. And so that has led me to Food for Aged Care, and it led me to meeting Ralph. And this passion that we have, that I've always felt food is medicine, yeah, if it's the right food. And all I've done, I haven't changed my cooking here. I've just taken, I'm the conduit, I feel, for Ralph's science. And he's taught me so much about choices. And I've tried to put all this together. But it's because of this shared passion that food can make all the difference to your life.
Well, Ralph is a dementia researcher, aren't you? You're one of the, experts.
I try to be. Thank you, Rita. But I'm also very grateful to you on behalf of all the dementia researchers, what you've done for helping Alzheimer's research by raising $200 million.
Yes.
Thank you.
Collaborated, yes. And I mean, you can't guarantee people won't get dementia if they, yes, follow these recipes, yes, but because we don't have a cure, yes, or a treatment, you can say that the food you recommend, the way you eat, could be a preventative factor.
I agree. I think it's going to be a very important preventative factor. And in Australia, we've been doing a major study called the ABLE study, where we followed 1,100 Australians for the last 10 years. And we looked at what they ate, and we looked at the other aspects of their lifestyle. And we clearly saw that people who adhered very strongly to what we call the Mediterranean diet had the lowest risk. So the amyloid, this is this toxic protein that builds up in your brain and kills your brain cells, is markedly reduced. And that's what basically made us excited of getting the message out there.
Take us through the Mediterranean diet for people who might not know what it's about. We know that it's lots of plant-based foods.
Yes, well, lots of plant-based foods, fish, little meat, dairy is fine, but everything is about moderation too.
Mm. Alcohol in moderation. Little's,
yes,
good.
But red wine. And so it's really the easiest group of foods that you could ever want to use, and exactly, it's how we live our life.
What are some good, easy tips? I mean, you've got this wonderful recipe book, and Peter and I were looking at it, salivating at the pictures. What are some simple tips that you could suggest to people at home that they could either whip up for lunch or for dinner tonight?
Great question. A bit of sourdough bread, a tin of sardines, a squeeze of lemon, and perhaps some beetroot relish on top.
Oh, wow.
You see, it's not about, yum, complicated food. Mm. It's about times you want to do really quick and simple things, and every part of that is giving you something special.
What about sugar?
Yeah, what are the bad guys?
Okay, well...
groaning from Ralph.
Yes, but all I want to say before Ralph does is don't deny yourself anything or you won't go on with having a good food life.
Definitely.
Because, but sugar is not good.
Yeah, I agree. And especially some of the drinks in particular, but also some of the juices. You know, fat was maligned for a long time, and that's now getting a recognition that a lot of good fats that we need to pay attention to. But unfortunately, sugar has taken that place, and it really is causing damage.
So if we actively engage with this, do we then see the rates of dementia drop away? Because our population is getting older.
Older, exactly.
We're going to have a massively aged, yeah, population. So dementia has potentially become a very profiled disease and condition. Mm. Do we see it drop away then? Can we defeat dementia by eating like this?
It's going to play a major role, but I don't think it's going to be the magic bullet in its own right. There's a big study going on in Europe called the Finger Trial, and in the US now it's called the Pointer Trial, where they're actually doing an intervention trial where they're taking the diet together with exercise as well as brain training. And together, for the first time, they're showing a reduction in cognitive decline. We've got no drug. In the last 40 years, there's been no drug that's had a major impact.
There's been a small study in the UK, yes, where there has been a reduction in older people. And again, they feel it's lifestyle changes, the ones Ralph and Maggie are talking about, that have been instrumental. That's why we say we can't guarantee you won't get dementia, but we do say this could be a preventive thing for you to do.
So the dementia, sorry, so dementia was around before the Second World War, but our sedentary lifestyle and our modern processed food generation has led to an increase in its prevalence?
Exactly. You're on the money. And, you know, the sad news for Australia is that, you know, we're going to have over a million people by 2050. It's the number one cause of death in women in Australia and number two in men.
Yeah.
I don't know why we stand out more than other countries, because in America it's number five. What? But it's a major issue. Unless there's a major medical breakthrough, we're going to have this disaster. But this is going to be one way in which we can prevent, and I believe prevention is going to be a huge player.
Mm.
One of our interesting studies that has come out, this ABLE study that we've done for 1,100 Australians, we can now look at the brain and we can basically diagnose Alzheimer's 20 years before any symptoms appear.
Yes. Wow. Yeah.
And that's where the exciting findings have come out, is that those who adhere closely to the Mediterranean diet have low levels of that toxic protein.
Right. But there's another element in this, and that is connection and being involved and sharing and being part of a community, having support.
Mm.
That's part of that Mediterranean idea as well.
Absolutely, it is. Yeah. Absolutely, that extended family, that eating together.
Mm. Can you cook for us?
Cook for the whole nation.
Yes.
She's doing one better. She's teaching the whole nation to cook.
And everyone in our studio audience can actually try out some of Maggie Beer's recipes themselves, because you're all taking her home. No, you're taking her book home. Thank you guys for coming in.